And we're back. I'm just screwing around, had a break. I'm now consuming some sort of delicious cinnamon thing that my roommates made. So it took me 6 weeks to eat on stream. But it's super yummy. I regret nothing. I'm also in the process of reorganizing a bunch of stuff. We're redoing the studio this weekend. And some people are having a conversation with me in Skyrim. So, we're going to finish Cinnamon Thing. So good. I don't know how to describe it. It's... imagine you had a cinnamon roll, but it was like a cake. Yeah, it's like a cinnamon roll or a cake, only better. So, there are some gentlemen. Who would like to chat with me. So let's take a look at that.
Bear witness, none will stand to oppose him.
The gods in Dragonreach say you
never should have come.
Uh-oh. Oh, good. Oh, also, meanwhile, while Janet is training on the mountain,
got some good pieces out here.
Let us turn our eyes to Elena, a woman of some potential. Heavy armor and a two-handed sword and a summons to the Jarl. Let's also loot these cultists and pay no attention to who they are. I do have some boss-looking robes, though. Also learn that spell we just picked up. So she, as you can tell, is sort of a straight edge kind of person. Responsible. She's also got her dragon tattoo, though. How much money do we have? I don't know, because I left it in my house. Well then, that's a problem. Because our fortress, now that's what she is. She wears heavy armor and uses fire spells. So we're actually gonna do something about that. So I'm going to briefly turn off the god mode I had on so I can empty my inventory without getting slowed down. So we want Earthbound Weapon. Oh, no one. So we're going to clear the spells out with Akato's recital, and then we're going to redo them. So for her, we're going to want Earthbound Weapon. We're going to want Salamander Touch. She uses fire spells. Dragonborn might have Breath of Fire. She's a Heart of Fire. I think we're also going to throw some Divine Armor in there. And we'll favorite up our steel longsword. So a mercenary with a summons. I feel like she's also related to Janet somehow. But I think it's unclear how. We're going to go and see the Jarl. Jarl Balgruuf of Whiterun.
You've done a great service for me and by my right as Jarl. My name, I assign
and
you...
And be named Thane.
Also note, we are back to business, Proventus.
Woman of ambition.
Yes, ma'am.
She'll become Thane of every hold before we're done.
The Jarl has appointed me to lead the way.
Come with me, Lydia. We're gonna wreck some shit.
Another wanderer here to look.
Listen, kid, shut up. So, we want to become Thane of everywhere. Political ambition is Elena's game. None of this, you know, wreck your face warrior stuff. Every move has a purpose. No shouts. Only whatever fire spells we can put together, which currently, by the way, is... oh, we have Fire Blast. So, that's good. So let's put that in two. So we do at least have a fire spell. We have a companion. Our house Carl. Lydia is apparently the most often married character in Skyrim. Spoilers, we're not going to marry Lydia. Because it's weird and awkward. I mean...
From Squire to Squire.
Let me talk to this guy for a second.
Take a look.
Sweet.
Till next time.
Because she works for us. Like, she's our in our employ.
Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came
halted
by and
stream
left
camp,
spell.
Eh?
Oh, need anything else?
Seems legit.
Just let me know.
We're gonna carry out duties for Jarls. And create not just the legend. Like Janet is about legend. Elena is about legacy. Janet's up on the mountain learning to shout. Elena is down here, killing bandits, slaying necromancers, trying to build the hold into something that matters, something that means something. And to answer the question of when we unlocked Elena, the answer is the moment we became Thane of Whiterun. So, we cheaped out a little bit on it just for dramatic effect.
City's quiet enough now.
She's rolling heavy armor, which means we don't have a lot of skill in that. It's the other thing about playing with the multiplicity is you tend to have to broaden your skills a bunch because you wind up getting good at something and then switching characters. For those of you who are just joining us, Elena is the same character we were playing before. She just looks different. And so what we get is the effect of being in the same world as these other people, but telling our own story. Are those Imperials or are they Stormcloaks? Those are totally Imperials. Yeah, those are Imperials. Alright, they're cool. I don't know that Elena really has a side in the storm, like in the Civil War, at least until after the battle for Whiterun. In which case, I think she will firmly side with Whiterun, obviously, where she was first made Thane, where her greatness was recognized. What's up, punks? Carve our way through these bastards. Who wants some? Who's over here? Hello?
Can't win this.
Covered in gore. Loot magnet all those bodies. Heal up. Pay no attention to that sign. We're gonna need that sign later. Lydia's just rocking it. Her armor's actually better than ours. We are in our first iron mine. We pay no attention to the traps instead. Oh, I missed. Oh no. Oh, I didn't miss that time. All right. Now, down here, we're going to have another bandit chief. First. Oh, yeah. One, two, three. Get out of here. Lydia, tank him for a bit. Pretty pleased with knobs on. There we are. Well, can we use our harvest spell? So you can see that it's harvesting iron from all of the veins. It's just, I find it's a huge time saver. And in addition to being a huge time saver, it just keeps me from having to run all over the place, do a bunch of fetch quest style flower picking. Now we're up to about 1,000 gold. Super nice. We get any new spells? We got 2 new spells. And a full set of barbarian armor. The cultist stuff. Nothing that's really doing us any favors except for some boots that we should probably put on. So we have the Axe of Whiterun. Every hold gives you a weapon when you become their Thane. And I have special plans for those. Not to worry. And let's go check out our buff spells. So Divine Armor leveled up. So we can have it regenerate health, give us a chance to dodge attacks, just increase our armor, deflect damage. I think we're going to go with decrease spells mana cost, though. At least for now. Pyromancer, check our Salamander Touch. So Salamander Touch burns everything around us. But we're not quite there. And Druid. We're going to check Earthbound Weapon. Earthbound Weapon is almost there. Not quite. Do we have Phoenix Strike? Oh, we do. Okay. So now we're going to get into some like complicated binding stuff. So now I can bind my multiple powers or abilities to one key. Here's my touch. And what that lets me do is now I'll have my own Phoenix Strike ability in addition to my longsword whenever I pull that out. If you are playing Skyrim for whatever reason and you don't have Sky UI, oh my god, it's amazing. It is wonderful. Let's go with decreasing the cost of fire spells, because then we can start getting into tossing dangerous fire spells around and being a pyromancer. Iron Greatsword of Sapping, Necklace of Minor Alchemy, which is going to do our alchemists a bunch of favors, and another Steel Longsword. Not bad. Let's learn those spells. So we got Arcane Weapon, which is going to be great for our Spellblade. Cursed Rune, which is going to be great for basically no one. And Transmute Mineral Ore, so we can turn iron into silver, silver into gold. So here we are. Grabbing these mammoth tusks, partly because we need them for our quest, but also because we can make some pretty cool swords and bows out of them. And again, that'll probably be a bonus stream thing, or I'll do it off stream. We'll see. Yes, aren't we beautiful? When we hop back, turn in that money, we're going to fast travel. Because shockingly, we don't walk everywhere. Because, I mean, walking everywhere is fun for a while, but sometimes when you're just running some errands, you just want to fast travel. Besides, we're about to do a whole bunch of walking. First things first, we'll turn in that bounty. Have the seneschal? I guess he's the Preventus is the seneschal. He's the advisor. Acknowledge our valor. Ooh, yeah, we did. Hmm. That's the statue of, I almost said Ruthgrad, it's not. It's the statue of Ysgrimor, who's the first companion. We are hungry, thirsty, and tired. We really need to go to the
Excellent. You've done us a great service.
Here is your it's okay, because that's where we need to go to get our next bounty anyway. And in the meantime, we'll stop there, we'll fill up our water, we'll eat some food, maybe buy some groceries. Actually, let's just drink the moat. No longer thirsty. Eat some food. The reason why we do it right there, because I'm a super nerd, is I can come over to the shrine and get my diseases cured. So drinking from river water, drinking river water when in proximity to shrines, good. And eventually we'll get spells or potions where we can cure our own diseases. So it's not as bad.
There's a root here in Skyrim. Can't neither imagine.
Come on in. Let me know if you need anything. Take a seat by the fire.
Oh god, the wall didn't render. Oh no. Neither did a bunch of the people. There's everyone. There's most people. Oh god. This is terrifying. Let's step outside. And pretend we never saw that. Oh dear. go back in.
Need something?
Oh, that's much better.
Steve.
You know, for a moment there, I thought your whole inn had just, like, vanished into some sort of extra-dimensional space, but I guess
how about
that's not what happened. Look at this. That's good.
Some of the Yard's men came by and
Silent Moon Camp. Nice. Yeah, let's fill my bottles with water. And let's rent a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room right this way.
I know where my room is. Thank you.
Just let me know.
That's not it. Maybe you don't. They let me into grad school. Did I tell you that? Like fighter grad school. We'll take off at night.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Oh, we're well rested.
I'm not
How are we doing in terms of
to stand around?
This
is
an
we're doing just fine.
Staunch protectors. Yes.
And there was a Red Guard lady in here earlier.
How can I help you? What would
yeah,
you like me to play?
Him.
Only two Imperials request that.
Damn right, Age of Aggression.
Yes.
Yeah, did you know that there's some black guys looking for a black lady? Oh, no. She's like, oh my god, it's me. I'm like, really? Out of all the people? I don't really trust her though. Well, let's go with her. You gonna Holforth, you need to get out of the way. Buddy?
Hey.
I need you to not be there. Oh my god, she teleported. She's gone. Mikhail. Mikhail, I will not have you singing bullshit Stormcloak songs in here. Are you going to are you threatening me? It seems unwise.
So the Alakir know where I am? Tell me. You can't tell them. Please, I need your help, and there isn't any...
What do you want?
I'm not the person that the people of Whiterun think I am. The men who are looking for me, the Alakir, I need you to root them out and drive them away before they find me. And they're mercenaries, only in it for the money. I don't dare show my face. Let
sure.
I heard one of them. Please. I know I'm asking you to do something difficult.
You know
Maybe
what?
Even
yeah, why
you
why
think
aren't you?
Hiding? These men are ruthless, cunning, deceitful. They'll pay off whoever.
They were bothering a random lady on the side of the road.
Guards and Jarls can be bought. And the Alakir are close.
Jarls can be bought.
So I'm choosing to trust you.
Not this Jarl. Not Balgrove.
No,
I'm gonna go talk to the Alakir about you. Maybe like in the abstract. But seriously. Cunning and deceitful. I found them bothering a lady on the side of the road being like, are you the person we're looking for? You're a black lady. We're black dudes. Seriously. How many black people are there in this country? She's like, I've lived here for a long time. My family. Fuck off. Oh my god. It was embarrassing. For them. Silent Moon's camp is up there. Where is Rorikstead anyway? Because where we're going to go is Morthal. There's a couple different ways to get there, and I don't know which way we're going to go, but we're going to clear out the Silent Moon's camp on the way. So that's going to be exciting. Is we're going to go visit all the other holds, and of course we've never been to Morthal before, so the way we are getting there is walking. Yeah, that's a dead body in the middle of the town, Brent. That was a cultist who insisted that he was the real dragon, or that he worships the real dragonborn. And I was going to let the disagreement just sort of stop at that. And then he opted to, fight me. And that was a bad idea. Hello. Bandit. Oh! Oh, sorry about your head. Sorry about the... irreparable damage I just did to your head. That looked super painful. Yeah, this is Elena. Elena is not like Janet. I mean, she's reasonable. You can negotiate with Elena. You can talk with her. She has ambition. She's all about legacy. She just wants to build something. But I mean, if you draw down on her... Well, I mean, enjoy the last, like... 10 seconds of your life. Alright. The Silent Moon's Camp. Just look at this. Not that. That, I think, is a weird rendering error, but... What's up, crabs? Bye, crabs. Did you just shoot an arrow at me? Uh-oh. Okay. Life is unfortunate. We need to think quickly. We got jammed up on that. We got jammed up, and now we have people throwing ice spells at us, which is slowing us down. Alright, you. Boom! You're dead. We got two people up there. That's super cool. Apparently you don't have enough magic to fight them. So let's just run up and kill them. What's up, friends? You're dead. Everyone's dead. Oh man, yeah, no, I really sort of almost bit off more than I could chew there. Six people's a lot of people. Ooh, hat. Let's put that hat on. So, it's not our iron helmet, but it is a circlet that's going to make our fire spells cost less to cast. So, that's useful. The Lunar Forge. So, we were at the Moon Forge earlier tonight. And that lets you make Lord of the Rings weapons. The Lunar Forge specifically lets you make lunar weapons, which have an enchantment where they burn under the light of the moon, which, as you can imagine, given that it's only out half the time, is super useless. Son of a bitch. Let's try something real quick. Let's carefully look. We might be out of luck, actually. Okay, we've got an autosave at the Bannered Mare, and we've got an autosave coming out of Whiterun. There's a bug with, I forgot that there's a bug with Salamander's Touch. So we're going to see if we can clear it. With another fight. But it's the interaction of a couple of different mods. But it's a bug where the visual effect always stays on. And I completely forgot that it was a thing. So we're gonna see what happens when it runs out. But it means we're just going to hang out here for a bit. Because I don't want to save over any of our autosaves. Meantime, we're going to clean out our inventory and assume that everything's going to be fine. Completely forgot about that bug, and I was like, oh man, it's going to be so cool. We're going to burn everybody. I mean, we look awesome, but we don't always want to be on fire for the rest of ever. So let's just wait. Yeah, we definitely caught that one. Okay, we're gonna need to reload. And we're gonna need to clear that out of our... Yeah. Pack mule, listen, alright. We don't call our companions pack mules. It's unkind. It's uncalled for. They're people. These are people who work for us. And who we can fall in love with, and those are not the kinds of people that we refer to as pack mules. So we're going to real quick deal with this salamander's touch bug by clearing it out and never ever casting it again. To go do the camp again, but such is life. Phoenix Strike teleports us over to them. Well, it charges us over to them and then knocks people over. It's awesome. And as a melee character who specializes in fire spells, it's basically rad. But I think it's got like a 3-minute cooldown. But instead of shouts... Yeah, no, I really love the spell, but the fire effect when it glitches, and I don't like spells with visual sort of cloak effects. Because that can happen. It happened on an old game, and yeah, you've just got to basically pave the save, which reminds me, let's do a real save. So, I'm glad we caught it when we saw an autosave, and we didn't have to, like, erase all of today's progress. Just, you know, the last 10 minutes. And maybe I won't completely embarrass myself, while fighting these bandits again. What's up, Archer Dude? Oh, I'm in your face! It doesn't hurt them, it just knocks them over. My sword! My sword hurts them. Oh, I'm out of stamina. Come on, come on, come on. Alright. Fine. Oh dear. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna drink a couple healing potions, just top ourselves up here. We're gonna get our sword back out.
Enjoy killing you.
Cool! Call that a knife? This is a knife. Who's shooting at me? Did you just shoot your friend? Heal up. Pay no attention to the arrows literally jutting from my back. Ooh. Oh my god, he poisoned me! He earned that. That I honor you, Ponin, for that. Left with the back piercings. Elena's got some sick tattoos. I don't remember if she's got a full back tattoo, but. That's the thing, this game, like, the increased bandit difficulty can make this game pretty tough. So we're actually going to charge this archer rather than wasting our Phoenix Strike on him. Oh, it's two groups of bandits fighting. Yeah, that's the other thing, is you can get bandit patrols, and they'll fight other bandits, and if you come across two of them, you're in for a bad time, as I was. So many mods. Raise our smithing. Did we loot the chest? I don't remember. Yeah, we totally did. Yeah. Alright, so now we're not ablaze with fire. Save our game. Go inside. Excuse me, Avon. Someone is dead. Uh-oh. Too greedy. Too greedy. Now slow. Oh, doesn't matter. Lydia, can you hold some of this? Appreciate it. We didn't find the necklace of, or the circle of destruction again, which sucks, but such is life. We did, however, find the amulet of the minor knight. So that'll improve our armor defense. So it's a little more useful for us, a little more topical. Oh. Mouse, why? No! Let's draw my mouse on the floor, my cordless one. And abracadabra, everybody's naked. Including that guy. I don't always loot everybody, although I will say that loot magnet makes it a lot easier to do that. But I do loot people. It's like, what was that? Yeah, that was, we picked that up last week. Loot magnet is a spell. Ooh, Timberwolf Cloak of Resist Magic. Don't mind if I do. Loot magnet is a spell that essentially loots all the bodies in a radius. Oh, there's our big fire spell, is Meteor Shower. Fire spells basically come in three sizes. Fire Blast, Conflagrate, and Meteor Shower. You'll note that We don't even have enough mana to cast Conflagrator Meteor Shower yet. Like, we just can't do it. Fire Blast, though. Good times. Let's put on that cloak. Oh, hello. You look salty. You were. Goodbye. Oh yeah, yet. We are gonna get there, believe me, you me. Okay, so let's turn off the bounty notice. And we are heading up to Morthal to meet with the Jarl there and see if we can do her any favors. And while we're doing that, we're gonna head over to Rorikstead and meet with those Alakir, those Redguard, and see what they wanted, because that lady was super suspicious. Oh my, me is just killing helpless animals. Boom! Get him on the wing! Oh no, so slow. We're so close, and yet so far. Those are not future Mire Lurks. Those are mud crabs, and they're adorable. I, for one, will always adore mud crabs because of the mud crab merchant in Morrowind. He just lived on an island and had 10,000 gold pieces for no reason at all. He was lovely. Alright. We leveled up. So let's go look at Forgotten Magic. Check our spells, Paladin. So we leveled up our Divine Armor. Why don't we increase our armor rating? And did we also leveled up our Earthbound weapon, so why don't we get the stamina regen? So now it's going to make us a more effective melee combatant. Combatant? Man, do I speak English today? Boom! It's the only way to travel. Hop! That was actually a really bad idea. Please come up for time again. It's gonna take like 2 minutes. Oh, we're gonna have to kill this wolf, probably. Oh, Phoenix Strike is ready. Awesome. Yeah, we don't have all those spells, and we can't cast nearly all of them. But Forgotten Magic gives you a suite of spells that level up on their own. And the result, one of the results of that is, oh, there it is, Saber Cat. One of the results of that is you can get some pretty cool stacking effects with it. Also the ability to summon your own wolves and fit, and all the magic in Forgotten Magic is designed to fit an archetype. So you've got Pyromancer stuff, Cryomancer, Druid, Warlock, which we might get into next week, because we did, I'm pretty sure, unlock our Warlock today, and I'll go through that in the spreadsheets at the end. Alright. But so one of the things that this winds up with me doing is Phoenix striking random things. Yes! Oh, we're so close to getting him in the air. Now, we're Phoenix striking semi-random things just to kind of level it up. B because especially as a character who doesn't have a lot of powerful ranged attacks, Phoenix Strike is what's going to help us kill dragons, and we are getting to the point where we're going to need to be able to kill a dragon. Last week, right at the end of the stream, we killed our first dragon, which means our clock starts. Anywhere 3 to 5 days after that, a dragon is simply going to drop out of the sky on our heads. And we need to be ready. Which means we need an amount of health and magic resistance. We need decently strong melee and ranged attacks. I think we're in pretty good shape. But Phoenix Strike is definitely going to be helpful, especially for Elena, for killing dragons. Theory, you get to live. Well done. I'm not about to try this on a giant. Super cash. You're just like walking through the woods and you're like, oh, look. Look at that. Whoosh. And just throw everyone around. Aren't there bandits out here somewhere? Wolves. See if we can ace one of those wolves with a Phoenix Strike. No, too far. There were two wolves. I'm not really worried. I mean, we have a giant sword. Not as big as last week's, but I don't think I'll ever need a sword that gets that's so big it gets me sent to jail again. And as of next week, the streams will start going up online. Because you can already watch them on Twitch in the previous streams, but they'll start going up on my YouTube channel at youtube.com/jtigba. So you can also check them out there, and that'll be pretty consistent for, I don't know, the rest of forever. Yeah, that deer is never... It's going to look back on this day and be like, what the hell was that? Oh my god. I'm so glad to be alive.
Come on in. Just stoke the fire. Take a seat and get the cool down.
Zashira.
Listen to me, stranger.
Sorry, oh, yeah.
But Zashira, she is loyal to the Thalmor. Her dear end.
You're loyal to the Thalmor. We're done talking.
Do you have new... You have? Where? Tell me now. Money? Now tell me where she is.
What's going on with this?
We cannot go out. You must bring her... Lead her to the Whiterun stables, outside of the city.
Well, alright. I guess we'll have to do that. Well, we're not going to do it right now. Next time, we're in Whiterun, which will be often. Basically our hometown. So we're going to Morthal. You guys look strapping.
If you've got some look like a senior,
I want to be in it. He says he needs blood. His name is Mralki, and he's the innkeeper. Thank you. I can't stand the
yeah, Eric. You seem like a cool days. Guy. I will bite. You are an okay. You seem like an okay person, and you would be a good adventurer. Rocky, let's talk about your son.
Eric, what about? But the world is a. What's more, he's got no armor. Have to save up the money.
I will give you money to buy your son armor.
No, Eric, I've changed my mind. All
right, this is what we do in the hold of Whiterun, where I am Thane. We take care of our people, and we help them reach for the goals that they want. Eric, where'd you go? Eric, you're like right over here.
Watch the skies, traveler.
Yeah, no kidding.
Do yourself a favor.
Did you have any luck talking to my
children? Your father has definitely changed his mind.
Maybe we can swap stories about our... My father, Ralki, manages the inn. He used to be a soldier. Oh, did you need something?
There you go. Congratulations on now being able to become a great adventurer. I'm glad that we had this talk. No, I mean, he needs armor, he needs weapons. See, the thing that I know is that when I come back here, Eric will actually be able to be hired as a mercenary named Eric the Slayer. And he's actually a pretty good warrior. He might even wind up marrying Elena if I can get away with that. I mean, he's a guy who chases his dreams. Seems like the kind of guy she'd be into. He isn't afraid of his own ambition. I mean, he isn't super proactive about it. He's kind of a shithead farmer, but we'll at least maybe hang out with him for a while. See if it is a phase. Alright, we are going to need to go around this mountain range. And I'm trying to do it without running through a bandit camp. Not because I'm afraid of bandits, because I think we've demonstrated that I'm super not. Ooh, we don't want to run afoul of that giant, though. Maybe we do. Let's save. Let's do this. Oh, this was a bad idea. The giant I'm gonna beat. The mammoth, maybe not. Time to go. Must go faster. Must heal my things. We got one of them. Are you like a vampire man? You can't cross running water? Ooh. Uh-oh, here comes. Not good. Sword. No, sword. There we go. Ha-ha! Elena Giant Slayer. Thank you. Oh, my combat buff just reactivated. There's a bunch of bandits over here. Guys, I just killed a giant. Did you see that? Are you sure that this is a good idea? No, they're running. Ooh, no, you don't get to run. Neither do you. Last, but not least. All right, fine. In the back. Bandits. They're so silly. What kind of person is like, that person just killed a giant. I think I'll attack them on purpose. Dumbasses. You're adorable. I just want to pinch your little cheeks to literal death. Lydia, we're a little close right now. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with this hotkey. Giant Slayer, Bandit Killer. Well, they're saying I don't want to run afoul of any bandit camps, not because I'm afraid to fight bandits, or giant camps for that matter, but because I have a strict rule about waiting until I actually get a quest to go there, before I go there, because otherwise you just sort of wind up slaying dragons and clearing stuff out and getting items sort of before... I don't know, before the game wants you to. There's definitely some spots for that. But just sort of before it's fun. So it's nice to wait until I get the quest and then sort of head in. And it's not like I'm, you know, hurting for things to kill. The fabled Skyrim mountain climbing that you just witnessed. Learned that in Morrowind. Started from the bottom like everybody else. I suppose that person is unfriendly. I bet they are. They're a thief. Oh, we're so close. Come on, come on, come on. Oh. Yep, that guy was definitely going to pick a fight with me and then going to attempt to kill me. There's Lydia, she's like halfway through the river going, I won't kill her. Yeah, I'm definitely... We did that earlier tonight. We wound up going, like, winding up at a random cave and going through it. I'm trying to sort of minimize... God, I can't speak English tonight. I'm trying to sort of minimize the distractions and the nooks and crannies and whatnot. Just because, A, I know we'll get to them all eventually, or we'll get to most of them eventually. And B, I like the notion that these characters have their own objectives and their own desires. So they're not just going to head out randomly and head into caves. They have stuff they need to do. Uh-oh. Oh. Not good. Our game crashed. That happens. It's okay. Means that in the next cell there was something that went wonky. It's all right. We've got a nearby save. This is the price of modded Skyrim. That and every time the game crashes, we drop a bunch of frames. Like, you know, 50 or so. As my computer just farts. All right. This is the cost of all our cool gear and spells and everything else. Our ability to freeze to death. We definitely saved after the giant, so that glory will live on. So where are we? We're on fire. Why are we on fire?
Oh.
Oh, it stopped. Okay. Good. As long as it stopped. We've done that once tonight already. So yeah, Phoenix Strike, the bug isn't present. It's Salamander Touch that causes that. The little sparkles that are coming off of us here are our other armor spell. Yeah, no, Lydia's a good time. Housecarls, my only problem with Housecarls is two problems really. The first is that they don't really have diverse skill sets. Almost all of them are strictly one-hand shield fighters, and it makes sense in it because you're gonna get them and use them to basically tank for you. They all wear heavy armor, they all... And the exception to that is the couple that were added in Hearthfire. So the the housecarl that you get after becoming Thane of Morthal, which is a surprisingly hopping town when you've got all the mods that I do, is actually a sorcerer. And he is super great. I completely forget his name. Welcome to Morthal, a city that definitely doesn't have any secrets at all, one bit, never.
Do you like magic? Thalion says I'm good at learning.
Hey Lydia, hold on to my firewood for a second. Correction, we're holding on to all of my firewood. Give me one piece.
Learning about magic.
Hogar. Please buy my firewood.
For honest work.
Sorry, what'd you say? Smile, oh, you're just like, hey buddy, what's up?
To me ever since, well, since
Alva's been
fire.
Good to me since the fire, eh? Okay. So it's this quiet, sleepy town in the middle of a swamp.
Stay out of trouble, Imperial.
Stay out of trouble. I always stay out of trouble. I resent the very implication that I wouldn't stay out of trouble.
I just try and do my job and not think about what
happened. Trying to think about what happened. What did happen?
My mother and father
Let's
died.
Let's go and ask the end. Spoilers, that guy is connected to that burnt down house out there.
Make it quick.
Look at our cool, glowing runic.
Welcome to the moor, son.
Yeah, what's the deal with that house? It's Rogar. It's Rogar's house. It burned down.
It's a real pity about his wife and kid.
And oh god, his wife and kid died.
Most folk won't go near it now for fear it's cursed. Rogar claims it was a hearth fire. Some folks say Rogar started
burned down his own house with his own.
That's what they say. See, he's living with Alva now.
Ooh.
That started the day after the fire.
That's some rough beats.
Moving in with a new love the day after your kin die like that. Aye. Our Jarl would sure like to know if he did, though. Might even pay.
Okay, sure.
There ain't much to offer, but if...
Also, here, you got any rumors?
Take a look at this.
Stay clear of the marsh. Anything
Big
else?
Talk of a little boy in Windhelm. Have you seen that shrine,
shrine
of
Azura?
They say the Dark Elves built
There's
it.
There's our first Daedric quest.
Psyched to see.
Where we need two Daedric quests to unlock our Death Knight. And that Dark Brotherhood quest is going to go a long way to unlocking our assassin.
What's the Jarl going to do about?
What are you guys mad about?
How are we supposed to feel safe in our own homes?
With Hrogar, like, murdering his wife like that?
I have told Ygritte of your concerns. She'll look after you all. Please, go about your business.
Really? You guys are all concerned about one dude who burned down his own house? Wizards? Bah, bored of you. Oh, there's wizards in our town. Listen, there's wizards all over the place. Deal. I get it. You're Vikings. You don't like wizards. Idgrad is
so,
awesome.
Life has brought you to Morthal and to me. Hrogar's house. My people believe it to be cursed. Hrogar. Many folk think he set the fire himself. Lust. The ashes were still on rumor and gossip? No. Sift through the ashes that up. Should you prove him guilty or innocent?
I mean, if I prove him innocent, then I prove him innocent. But I'm pretty sure he burned down his house, otherwise there wouldn't be a quest for it. There's probably not going to be a quest where you're like, oh, look at this. I wonder what happened to this house. Oh, everything was fine. What a tragic accident.
If those Whiterun guards can take down a dragon, so can you.
You might have to. Oh! Ah! So close and yet so far. Actually, I think we might close out the stream there. And finish up for the night. It's 9:30. And I've got to work in the morning. So... we'll get back into that... next Tuesday? Well, we're loading back in. Let's progress the quest a little further. Let's see what we can figure out. And then we'll get to the next phase of it. And then we'll wrap for the night. and we'll take a look at our spreadsheets. Arkay. Yeah, there are priests of Arkay everywhere. There's a big Hall of the Dead in Markarth, where you can do a couple of quests. And apparently the only cemetery in Skyrim is in Falkreath, and it's got like 10 people in it. Skyrim is both small and big.
What is it, Imperial?
Yeah, so we were like right down the street from the house. Like, we just faulted a load. Little tiny ghost girl.
Who's that?
Sure.
Help you. Are you a stranger?
I am 100% not a stranger. I am here to make friends with you, tiny ghost girl.
But I'm lonely.
Sure.
Okay. We have to wait for nighttime, though. I can't tell you. If you can find me first, I can tell you.
So we're going to play hide and seek with a tiny little ghost girl. This isn't spooky at all. Is it after dark now? No, it's like 11 in the morning. Get a room at the inn and sleep all day. Now let's also fix our mouse cursor. There we go.
Finally, someone comes in. Pick off your. I hear the steward asked you to look into the.
I saw Helgi's ghost.
Child is probably begging. Best tell the jarl.
No. I'll just talk to the girl. Can I rent a room? Yeah, here we are.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Alright. Let's sleep, and we'll meet up with Helgi's ghost at night. So we'll sleep for, say, 10 hours. So it'll be 10 o'clock at night. I will never understand the need for Bethesda games to count down. Just in case you're like, oh my god, I don't want to. I can't. Drink some water.
Need something? Yes.
Oh, we're gonna eat some food. What have we got? There we go.
Need something?
Yeah.
Is that her dog?
Yes.
Yeah, it is Murdoch. One of the mods I have puts caravan travelers in the game, so they travel around from town to town on routes with usually two merchants or a merchant and Ermengard.
What you want, hello, stranger? I have a date.
Hello,
with
new
the
friend.
And the chorus that calls it home.
I wanted to meet the one who braves the marsh.
And I'm honored to meet one so fragile.
Oh my god.
Squashing bugs I'm the polite.
We are so polite.
Don't worry, Trap. As for my name,
Anumla the Swamp Knight.
Once knew me as Anumla.
Okay.
But fighting so, Luke called me
Anumla
the Swamp Knight.
Is the funniest character I have ever met. She's part of a mod called Interesting NPCs. And we've seen a few of them as we've progressed, like the ghost in the prison. The difference between a lot of them and Anumla is Anumla can become your follower. So she can hang out with you while you travel around. And she's got commentary for everything because the people who designed her put a lot of love into it. And they knew everything that you'd probably wind up doing. Now, the only tricky bit is because I have a follower mod, I can't recruit her in the normal way. So I have to actually go into my mod, go to the settings, and recruit Anumla the Swamp Knight. And now we're super besties. And I don't care that she has the same skill set as Lydia, we're gonna hang out together and be super besties. So let's go and see if we can't find Helgi's ghost, which I believe is just up here. This Spoilers, I've done this quest before, because I've done all the quests before. Well, not all of them. What's up? Oh, that was an error. You made an error. Mistakes were made. I think that she's a vampire. I can tell because her name is Layla the Vampire. No, the actual reason why we have to... Oh, sorry, we're...
He wanted to play with me forever and ever.
She tried to...
He kissed me on the
oh my god. You made a kid into a vampire? You fucking monster. Did you not watch Interview with a Vampire?
She's dead.
It's awful. You end up with evil Kirsten Dunst.
She's a vampire.
I'm gonna sleep for a while now.
She's dead, Layla.
I thought she left it during the Stormcloak. Being a vampire is way better than being a Stormcloak, let me tell you. But no, the reason why we have to do that with Adam Law is because if I use the standard follower dialogue, it doesn't input her into the mod correctly. So not only can I not interact with her through the follower mod, but I can't ever have her, like, I can't leave her anywhere. So, no, we just use the back end of the mod. It's one of those things where you've got a mod interacting with another mod, and it's
I never got
weird.
To tell her. Goodbye. You think Alva?
Think Alva's a vampire? Yeah, I think that she is.
I refuse to believe Alva had anything to do with this.
All right.
There is no way.
I'll tell you what. We'll go talk to Alva. And we'll see what she has to say about it. And we'll just clear it right up. Oh, that's why everything's weird. Still got my marker on Morthal. We'll just go talk to Alva. We'll be like, hey, are you a vampire? And she'll be like, no, I'm definitely not a vampire. I definitely didn't turn the character that you found, who's known as Layla the Vampire, into a vampire. Doo-doo. This house is up here. It's locked. Are we feeling sneaky today?
Phony Hrothgar loved his child as much as this vampire did.
See?
I don't care what
Swamp Knight already paying off. She's got commentary for everything.
Has no excuse.
Are we sneaky? We're not sneaky. If we are not sneaky, then the guards will super bust us. Okay. Let's see if we can't open this lock. We have 30 lockpicks. Welcome, Steve the Vampire. Do I have to be called Steve the Vampire? Steve talks like that because of his fangs. It's a thing. Do I have to be called Steve the Vampire? It's like, well, yes. Excuse me? Ooh. What just happened? Life is complicated. I know what just happened. It was confusing. There we go. Okay. Don't mind me. I'm just going to go and look in your basement. Excuse me. She has a journal. My life is dreary. Where is my prince come to rescue me? Where is my bold Nord warrior to sweep me off my feet? I met a man today when picking night flowers. He's exciting and oh my god, it's Twilight. This is just literal Twilight. He's exciting and exotic. We kissed in the moonlight. It was so romantic. I'm going to see him again tonight. Now I understand the true colors of the night. Movarth has shown me the true black of night and the true red of blood. He's promised me a feast of blood if I do his bidding in Morthal. Great. Hrothgar was easy to seduce. Movarth said I should find a protector first, someone to watch over my coffin during the day. Hrothgar is perfect, except for the bit where he has a wife and child and a house of his own. We couldn't have picked literally any single guy moving into friggin' Morthal, you piece of crap. Laylet came to visit me tonight. She slaked my thirst. I've hidden her away to let her rise as my handmaiden. I've spread the rumor in the town that she left to join the war. Fools. If anything, vampirism improves penmanship. Like, you start out with that chicken scratch crap, and as soon as you're a vampire, it just turns into long, flowing script. Movarth has confided his grand plan to me. I am to seduce the guardsmen one at a time and make them my slaves. Then he and the others from the coven can descend upon Morthal and take the entire town. We won't kill them. They'll become cattle for our thirst, an endless supply of blood in an entire town to protect us from the cursed sun. Hrogar's family is becoming inconvenient. I've told Laylet to kill them all. But make it look like an accident. Hrogar must be seen as innocent if he's going to meet... You are the worst planner! Oh, to be fair, it's not your fault, I guess. Laylet burned Hrogar's family alive. I asked for an accident, and she gave me a scandal. To make matters worse, she tried to turn this little girl, Helgi. Except Laylet couldn't even get that right. She killed the child and left the body to burn. Something is wrong with Laylet. She keeps talking about Helgi. I think her mind has snapped. She seems to think the child can still be brought back to be her companion. There's a stranger in town looking into the fire. I'll have to be careful. Well, you fucked that up! You know who I think would really like to hear about this? The Jarl. We'll just go wake her up. Lydia? Lydia? Hun? Hun? I need you to keep backing up. Keep going. Just keep going. And this is why having followers in the indoors is tricky. There we are. You got anything to say about this?
I won't let you hurt Alva.
Really? Okay. I'll count to five.
I won't let you hurt Alva.
One. Two.
This town
three.
With tragedy.
Four.
It all,
I won't let you hurt Alva.
Five.
The Nords are
I'm gonna turn around. Yeah, that's what I thought. There's your protector, lady. There's your protector.
Everything all right?
You know what, Hrogar? It's not your fault. You got mind controlled by a vampire. You didn't kill your family. Lilac killed your family, and she's already dead. So you know what? I will give you a pass.
Out with it.
You get one.
What do you need?
All right, Jarl. Alva killed her.
Didn't think she had it.
She's a vampire.
I assume you have proof. Can't go make
Listen, read her shitty diary, please.
The traitorous bitch. Morthal, I'll gather together some able-bodied warriors to clean out Movart's lair.
Kill the master vampire. Tell you what.
Until next time.
We're going to do that next week. We're just going to open up and we're going to kill the master vampire. Ooh, Jesus! Oh, these are the people that she's gathered together to fight the, vampires. But that is where we're gonna wrap for tonight, so let's go to the spreadsheets. And let's take a look at, what we have accomplished today. In terms of, like, characters and stuff. Yay! And the desktop thing still works. So, we made some serious progress on Janet. Janet's already kicking ass and taking names. Helen is our warlock. We do have warlock spells now. We picked up Blight Curse and a couple other ones. So, Helen is now unlocked. So we can pick her up and do companions quests later. We haven't picked up the Thieves Guild quest yet, but that's the only thing stopping us from unlocking Clive. Pavel, we are doing the Morthal vampires, which means we're going to unlock Pavel and we're going to bring him in to take care of those vampires tomorrow, because Pavel's going to do Dawnguard and Pavel's our vampire hunter. Leona, she's going to do our Dark Brotherhood. She's a thief. Again, we're waiting for that Thieves Guild quest, so that's going to unlock a couple of people the next time we're... Probably the next time we're in Riften, because that guy's real insistent. Nicholas, we still don't have a... We have a couple of summon spells, but none that we can cast, and we don't have Courage. Elena, we became Thane. So she's unlocked. And she's kicking ass and taking names. She is related to Janet. I thought so. She's like alternate universe Janet. She's like Janet only responsible and ambitious instead of Janet like nonstop destruction. Lucretia. We have one Daedric quest. So let's see. One out of two. Because we got the Shrine of Azura quest. So if we wind up in Markarth, then we might wind up unlocking her when we get the Mace of Molag Bal quest. But we'll see. Roland. Roland's our Spellblade. And we haven't touched any of this, but we're not going to get into Roland until we hit the college anyway. And we can't hit the college until we have a spell skill at 25. So we're going to need to get some time in on Raiden. But I think that Elena can help us unlock Raiden with her destruction spells. Same with Helen. And Siegfried. We've done some bounties. All we need is a tier 2 sword or shield. So that's an Elven shield, or a Dwemer shield, or an Orcish shield. Any of that stuff, tier 2 or higher. Or a sword of the same variety. And we haven't found any of those yet. So we're going to probably need to be a little higher level before Siegfried unlocks. But let me tell you, it's going to be badass when he does, because he is going to kill dragons like nobody's business. It's going to be great. And then these four, we'll talk about them during the bonus stream. Which, I don't know when it's going to happen, but our inventory is real full, so it's going to have to happen soon. All right. And that is our stream for tonight. I am going to make some notes and probably crash. I'm going to try and get the mod list and the spreadsheet up on the website this week. But I'm also prepping for Maker Expo. Here, let me... So the website is jimtickle.com, which is down here. There we go. Sorry, my thing is weird. You can find additional videos at youtube.com/jtigwell or Wootsie Riot, which is where we do Minecraft videos and podcasts. And we are also going to be live at Maker Expo in Kitchener on September 10th, where we're going to be doing an 8-hour podcast. We're going to be interviewing painters and... I think we're lining up some balloon artists, roboticists, anybody we can to talk about making things and how they do it and what they do that's different. We're also going to try to get some poets and musicians, because nobody ever talks about poets and musicians as makers, and they totally are. So it's going to be a blast. We're going to be uploading podcasts all day. And you can heckle me on Twitter, @ConceptCrucible, but at any time. And other than that, I will see you all later. Have a good night.